Good afternoon, or should I say good evening, because it's just gone 5 p.m. Good evening, year six, and welcome to lesson four of your transition clubs. Today's lesson is going to be the wow lesson. I know you've all been looking forward to it, so I know a lot of you do enjoy PE, and from what I've heard, you've all been so excited about today's event, and we've kind of kept it a mystery and we've called it a wow. You'll soon be finding out what a wow means at BA. So as usual, just a couple of housekeeping. So let's start off by taking your phones, logging onto Slido, or you can just scan the QR code so you can then access the chat. I'm going to do exactly that myself. So I'll give you a couple of seconds to all join. So I'll go and join also. So I thought, let me make it fair. As you're joining, I'll be joining as well. So have you joined the chat window? Okay. Says beating me to it. I'm still trying to, believe it or not. Remember, I'm not the best when it comes to technology. Here we go. I'm almost there. It's just loading. Perfect. Right. So if you're coming in, don't forget when you log on, make sure you log on and make sure your name is tagged, just your first name only. And then let's find out what primary school you're from as well. And when you come in the room, feel free to say hi to myself, Miss Shallow, and hi to Mr. Sheehan, who's going to be taking you today's lesson. Okay, I think we're all set. So today's going to be slightly different from what you've experienced with the lessons that you've had in science and in art and in maths, because it's going to be a practical lesson. My chat window is just loading, so I can't see your hello. So if you're saying hello, I can't see them as yet. It's just showing me all my old messages. I need to filter in a way that I can just see just my today's messages. Right, so you need to make sure you've got enough space around you, because you're going to be moving around a lot. So make sure you've got plenty of space. Make sure you've got clothing that are flexible, clothing wear that you can actually get into the wow activity without having to, you know, struggle. You can't be wearing like your tight jeans, because you might not be able to, you know, stretch out. And so on and so forth. Right, so in a moment, I'm going to be passing you over to Mr. Sheehan, who's going to be taking you through the wow lesson. And then what would happen is, after Sir is finished, you would then come back to me. So any question that you have at that point, I'll address the questions, and then we'll do our shout out as always. Right, Mr. Sheehan, are you and your team ready?
Fantastic. Thank you, Miss. Afternoon, boys and girls. Welcome to the BAP department. You'll have to excuse me. Bad time in my voice has started to go the last couple of days. So if I sound a bit like a Dalek or something like that, don't worry. It's not my usual voice. So as Mrs. said, you are going to be doing a wow today. Now, obviously that term wow, all of our PE lessons are wow lessons. You'll come to this department, you'll be absolutely amazed by every lesson that you have, but WOW is actually an acronym for something else. So I'm sure lots of you have heard of Joe Wicks. Well, we actually started this before Joe Wicks. He just got lucky and got famous before we did. And WOW stands for Workout of the Week. So you'll have two PE lessons with us from September. One lesson you'll do a sport, and the other lesson will be a workout lesson. Within that workout lesson, what we like to do is we like to teach you a little bit of science that if you go on to study sports in years 10 and 11, it will help you with your knowledge you require then. And then you do a 20-minute workout. So we always start with a question. The question we have for all of our WOW lessons is, why do scientists say that exercise is a natural medicine for body and mind? So there are, when you're exercising, there are certain things that are going to happen when you're exercising that is going to help your mind, okay? It's going to help your mind become stronger and better. And the obvious one is going to help your body become better. And then within that, we look at a specific topic each lesson. And the one I want to look at with you today is, how does exercise help to build mental strength? Okay, so when you think about sport, And for those of you who enjoy football, so it's the easiest thing to talk about. Last night, there was a game between Rangers and Frankfurt. It went to penalties. On Saturday, there was an FA Cup final between Chelsea and Liverpool that went to penalties. And the players that step up to take those penalties, they have to be mentally strong. They have to believe that they are going to score that penalty. If they walk up and think, I'm going to miss this, it's not going to be good for them. Okay, so mental toughness is really important in sport. Mental toughness is also really important in life because you're going to face lots of challenges. So one of the things we want to think about is why we need to be mentally tough. And what advantage can this give us at school, both at work and on the sports field? So those are kind of the questions I want you to have in the back of your mind as we're talking about this. Now, you might have heard a phrase people say, might say to you, is your cup half full or is your cup half empty? So if I was to get a glass of water now and fill it halfway and say to you, describe that glass, like I said, some would say, well, it's half full, which means you have a positive outlook on life. Some might say it's half empty, which tends to mean you have a negative outlook on life. So I want to talk to you about two made up people, person A. Now, person A is always thinking half full, okay? The whole thing about life, everything is half full rather than being half empty. Every time they face a task, they look at it with a positive mindset. So it doesn't matter what they're doing. So if that person was you coming to this WOW today, when I tell you in a bit the five different exercises we're going to do, a person with a positive mindset would say, you know what? It doesn't matter that I've never done that before. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it to the best of my ability. In fact, I'm going to smash this workout. I'm going to be the best person on this lesson at this workout. Whatever task they get, they always complete it to the best of their ability. And that is the important bit. It doesn't mean they always complete it and get 100%. They complete it to the best of their ability. There are going to be things they're not very good at. When you come next year and you come to one of my dance lessons, you're going to realize I'm not great at dance. Okay, you'll learn that very, very quickly. However, when I do that dance, I will have to complete it to the best of my ability. There's going to be others of you that are going to come and do other sports. You're going to think, oh, I'm not very good at that sport. If you've got a positive mindset, you're going to listen to what my amazing staff say. You're going to follow the drills. You're going to get better at it. You might struggle. You might start to feel, oh, I'm rubbish. I can't do this. But because your outlook is positive, you're going to find a way to get around that obstacle and you're never going to give up. When you do this well today, this workout, if you do it properly and you push yourself, you are going to get tired. You've got a choice. If you're going to be the kind of positive person, you're going to say, yes, my arms are going to ache from doing press-ups. I'm going to have a quick 10-second rest, and then I'm going to go again, and I'm going to try and get another three out. And then when that gets too tired, you'll have another rest, and so I'm going to get another two. Okay? You're never going to give up. That is your positive mindset. That's what person A is like. Person B, though, is the opposite of that. Life is always half empty. They're that kind of person who they always look at the negatives, never the positives. Oh, I'm not very good at football, so there's no point in me trying. I'm not very good at cricket. What's the point? I'm going to try and hit this ball, and it's going to hit my stumps. Okay? When they are challenged, they just reject and give up. They kind of stand there, don't even bother trying, let the ball hit their stumps and walk off again. They lack mental toughness. And the worst thing about that is they pass negative feelings onto those around them. Okay, so if that is you, today's a day, it's the start of a new day. We want you to be like person A. Okay, we want you to have that mental toughness, not just the sport. You're going to sit exams when you come to this school. Are you going to sit in front of that exam paper and be, oh, I can't do it, and put your pen down and not bother? If you do that, you're never going to achieve anything. Or are you going to pick your pen up and say, well, I'll give that one a go? And if you pick up 10 marks, that's fantastic. That's 10 marks more than you would have got if you didn't do it. So the question for you is, when we do the workout today, who is likely to get a better score? Who's likely to do more reps? Who's likely to be able to do more of each exercise? Is it going to be person A, who tries their best, they struggle even when it's hard and they never give up? Or is it person B, who's just going to be like, well, I can't do that. I can't be bothered. So that's the little bit of science. So that gives you an idea of the kind of thing that we would go into in a lesson. Now, obviously, if you were in front of me as a class, I would have given you lots of opportunities with the people next to you to discuss things so that you learn off of each other. Okay, but that's the kind of thing we look at the start of a WOW. So what we're going to do now is we're going to get onto the bit you really wanted to do. We're going to get onto the workout. Now, I need to tell you this. If you do this properly, there's going to be a high chance tomorrow morning when you get out of bed, okay, you're going to be lying there and you're going to go to sit up and be like, oh my goodness, my stomach's killing me. And you try to get your legs out of bed and you're going to be like, oh my goodness, my legs. Killing me. That's into the hospital. That means you've done a fantastic workout and your muscles are developing. All right, so we will give you some help at the end of this workout to stop your muscles aching. That's why we do a cool down and a stretch. Another thing you can always do is find a tennis ball and rub your muscles, and that moves all the lactic acid out of them. All right, so please do not worry tomorrow morning if you wake up and you ache. It doesn't mean you get Friday off of school. The best thing you can do is actually go into school, move around, do lots of movements to get the muscles up and running. So today's WOW, the workout, is known as an EMOM, E-M-O-M. That means every minute on the minute. So you have basically a 1 minute workout, 1 minute to do one exercise. And then when that minute changes, you do the next exercise. Now, we're not going to be that cruel to you now. It's the first WOW that you've ever done with us. So what we're going to say is for 40 seconds, you work. And then for the last 20 seconds of the minute, you get a rest. Now, it's really important you use that rest. It's going to be very tempting when that rest is there for you to want to curl up into a ball, all your breathing, that kind of stuff. All right. It's really, you're going to want to do that, but it's really important you don't do that. It's really important you stand nice and tall, arms above your head, and allow yourself to get lots of oxygen in. We've got five exercises you're going to do, and you're going to do them for 4 rounds. Okay. So you're going to repeat each exercise 4 times. The first one you're going to do is burpees. The second one you're going to do is ab crunches or sit ups. The third one you're going to do is known as high knees. The fourth one you're going to do is press ups. And the fifth one you're going to do is known as air squats. And I will show all of those to you in a minute. Just a little bit more information. If you don't take all this in, don't panic. You get years to learn it all. I'm just going to tell you about the muscles you're going to use as well as we go through them. So I'm hoping you can see me. I'm going to show you a burpee. Mr. Penny is just going to go around and control the camera, I think, so that you can see me. Can you just take that a little bit, Mr. Penny? Fantastic, brilliant. Okay, don't worry if you can't see my head. That's all right. So a burpee, you start standing up. Okay, for a burpee, your hands go down by your feet. All right, flat on the floor. You kick your legs back into a press-up position. Your chest touches the ground. You push up again. Your knees come back to your elbows. You stand up and you clap. Okay, so I'll do that in full speed. All right, so you go down, jab, up, and clap. That would be one burpee. All right, now the burpees, just so you know, sorry, so can you lift the camera up a bit? Fantastic, thank you. So a burpee uses your deltoids, which are in shoulders, uses your pecs, which are in your chest, triceps and biceps in your arm, your quads at the front, your glutes, which is your bottom, and your calf muscles, your gastrocnemius. If you can't remember all of that, don't worry. This is just to show you again. We try to teach you all those things. So that's the first thing you're going to do. Mr. Hills, another one of my teachers, and myself will do it with you. We'll take it in turns, so don't worry. You'll have something, and maybe Mr. Penny will jump in as well. So you'll have people to watch. Number two is ab crunches, or sit-ups, as you call them. Now, the way we like to do sit-ups here is we like to put our feet together, okay? We start with our hands above our toes. We go all the way back, touch the floor behind us, and come back up and touch the floor in front of us. Okay, so they are called sit-ups. They're also ab crunches, like so. Okay, so that's the second thing you're going to do. Obviously, ab crunches work your abdominal muscles. The third thing you're going to do is just that classic high knees. So this is quite a high intensity. You're just going to stand there and you're going to jog on the spot on your tippy toes, pumping the arms and really bringing your knees up as high as you can. All right, and obviously this again works your quads at the front, your hamstrings at the back of the legs. your glutes, your bottom muscles, and your gastrocnemius at the bottom or your calf. So that's the first three. Then we move into press-ups. You should know the press-ups. So there's two ways of doing press-ups. The first way is the proper way. So I think you can see me sign on. Yeah. All right. So I'm on my toes, I'm on my arms, keeping my core, which is my belly and my back, straight. I bend at the elbows, my chest touches the ground, and I push up again. Okay, that'd be one, that'd be two. If you want to get the idea, but you're not sure to do it, you can do a hand release press up. When you go to the floor, you take your hands off and you push up. If you can't do that press up, we do a half press up, where you rest on your legs just above your knees. So you rest on your quads. So I push my legs there, I lock my feet behind me, and again, just bending at the elbow, down and up. Okay, so that's your press ups. The last one, press ups, of course, will give you your pecs, your chest, your triceps at the back, some of your biceps at the front, your deltoids in your shoulders and your abs as well. Last one is air squats. Okay, so I start standing straight. Now I find it easier to, when I throw my hands forward, because I've got to bend my bottom. Okay, so I tend to put my hands forward, bend my bottom and come back straight. Now when I bend my bottom, I want my bottom to go lower than my knees. Okay, so it should go down to there, like so. All right, so hopefully that should show you all of those. Those are my air squats, and they do my quads, my hamstrings, and my glutes. So that should give you an idea of what the wow is going to be. So what I need you to do now is I need you to find a space so that we can start this wow. It's going to take 20 minutes to do it, and then we'll be done. So 20 minutes of high intensity exercise. So I'll give you 1 minute to get yourselves ready, and then we'll get going. Okay, right. So what's going to happen is through the system, you'll hear some music, all right? And you'll hear a voice as well that will tell you pips go to start, and then it'll pip, and then you'll have a break. So I'll explain it all as we go through. So are you ready? Let's just work all this out. Okay, so I'll start the timer. We've got 10 seconds before we start, and we are going to start with burpees. Go! 10 seconds before we start the burpees. We're going to go to ab crunches next. Rest. Okay. In a minute, when the pips go again, high knees. Next bench. Bye, Mr. Hills.
Rest.
Press ups in a minute, 20 seconds. We got press ups.
Is it 20 seconds rest?
Yeah.
Try and set yourself a target, year sixes. Try and set yourself a target. Let's go.
Let's go.
Where's the music, sir?
Sorry.
Halfway there. Ten seconds. One more, come on, dig deep for one more. Look for that next one. Last few seconds, keep going, just the music stopping.
Rest.
And have a break and rest.
We're going to knees, high knees.
Yeah.
All right, taking the oxygen, have a little sip of water. All right, high knees, we're going for. Are you ready?
Let's go.
Knees up. Okay, and rest. All right, whilst you're doing this, anybody watching the screen, have a think about Mr. Hills and me. Which one of us is person A? Which one of us is person B? And think why person B might be using it as if something as an excuse not to do it. Okay, press ups, let's go!
Halfway there. Ten seconds. Rest.
Okay. Taking a big breath. We've got air squats to go, and then you're halfway through the workout. Almost. Okay, fantastic. Some people think Mr. Sheehan's B, Mr. Hills is A. Okay, good. Can you come up with the reason why Mr. Sheehan might be B?
I'm a bit busy, sir. I'm a bit busy.
Halfway there.
Get a drink.
Okay, fantastic. You're halfway through. We've got to do each round twice more. So you've got burpees twice more and crunches twice more. When you're taking a drink, little sips, do not take big gulps. Are you ready? Come on, let's really push it for this last half. Ready? Go! Okay, we welcome Mr. Penny to the party now. He's jumped in from me.
Halfway there.
Halfway there. Keep going. Come on, find another five.
10 seconds.
Fantastic, okay, so grab your rest, we've got ab crunches to go. All right, if we've got 40 seconds, let's really aim for 20 ab crunches. If you can do more, fantastic, 20 is the target. One every 2 seconds. Are you ready? Set. Bang them out. Go.
Let's go.
Seconds. 10 seconds. down into high knees.
Hopefully you have a swell on by now, guys. High knees, let's go.
Hey, high knees, let's go. Okay, good. Right, 20 seconds. We're into press ups. Right, you've got 7 minutes left. Let's make them a big 7 minutes. Ready for those press ups? Here we go. Let's go! Come on! Dig deep! Dig deep! What can you find in there? Dig deep! Look for it! Come on! Look, aim for another five! Dig deep! Aim for
remember
five more! Fantastic. Okay, air squats now. Give your arms a little bit of a break. Move into air squats. We have 6 minutes left. Big 6 minutes. Don't give my love.
Seconds.
fantastic effort. Three things to go. High knees, press ups, air squats. Let's go, guys. Big effort. Last 3 minutes.
Let's go.
Fantastic, boys and girls. Give yourselves a round of applause. One hand to Hilsey, one hand to Kenny. Fantastic performance there. I know you want to sit down. Don't do it. It is the worst thing you can do right now is sit down. So what we're going to do is we're just going to take you through a few stretches that you can do now, and then you can do these stretches afterwards to really help yourselves out. So we'll start with the upper body. We're going to start with the arms. Take one arm, put it across your chest. With the other arm, just slowly behind the elbow, pull it in towards you. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Give it a shake, swap arms. Okay, pull it across so you can feel that muscle pulling. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Give them a shake. When we do these in lessons, we normally call out the odd numbers. You call out the even numbers. We can't do that. Okay, arm down, bring your back and push down. Let the shoulders down your back nicely. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Give it a shake and change. Okay, other arm. Once again, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Shake it out. Okay, so there's a few stretches you can do for the top of your body. Some shoulder rotations will help with that. We'll have a quick look at the abs now. We're going to go on the floor. Don't worry, we're not doing press-ups. It might look like it. Okay, lie flat on the floor, and then keeping your legs on the floor, you're just going to push up with your arms to the base. The base of your back is arched to try and get those abs a little bit of a stretch out. Hopefully you can see one of us in the camera doing it. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. and I might not get up from this position again. Okay, once more. Push up, really stretch those abs out. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and up we get. Fantastic. So that's something you can do to have the abs. You can also, for the abs, stand up and push your hips forward, okay? And you should feel a nice pull here in your abdominal region just to keep them stretched out. Those are probably going to be the most painful ones tomorrow, as you know, we don't use those a great deal, so they'll really start to ache. We're quickly going to do a couple for the legs. So if you need to, you can always put your arm on somebody for balance, hold the opposite ear, hold the wall. This one's for the quads. Try and keep the knees together. Okay, push your hips forward. You should feel it here. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Give that a shake. Change legs. Balance out the opposite way. Try and keep your knees together. Don't do what I'm doing. That doesn't help. Knees together. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Give that a shake. And then we'll just do two more. One for the hamstrings. So some of you, my flexibility is poor. Okay, so some of you, if I just do this, that's about as far as I can get to feel the stretch at the back. If you're more flexible than me, you can keep your legs straight, push back through your legs. You should feel the pull on the back of your hamstrings here. You want to do it till you can feel that. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. And again, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Fantastic. And then the last one, give a shake, is for your calf muscles, your gastrocnemius at the bottom. So I take, if I do it sideways, I take a step forward with my right leg. I keep my left leg straight, the heel on the ground. I just slowly push my right knee out, and I should feel it at the bottom of my left leg below the knee in the calf muscle. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Swap over, step forward with the left leg, keep the right leg straight. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Have a good shake. Ladies and gentlemen, I would love to know your scores. If you want to put them into the chat, if you can remember any of them, that'd be fantastic. Hopefully you are sweating. Good job you can't see us here because we are. If you have any aches and pains in the morning, no, do not take the day off school. All right, go to school, move around, do some of those stretches if they're really bad. Get a tennis ball. If you don't have anything else, roll it around on the muscles that ache and move the lactic acid out of them. I really hope you've enjoyed that. The thing I love about the WOW is it doesn't matter how good you are at football, rugby, netball, any of those sports, anybody can do really well at a WOW if you put the effort in. So thank you so much for joining us today. We hope you've enjoyed that. I believe you have a worksheet to fill out on it, and there is a checkout to fill out. I'm going to hand back to Miss Shallow. I'm sure if there are some questions or anything like that, she'll let me know. Big round of applause, please, gents, for Mr. Hills and Mr. Penny. We'll give you a big round of applause. I'll hang around for a little bit. I think Mr. Hills and Mr. Penny need to go home and have a well-earned shower. Thank you, gents. No. Thank you, ladies and gents. We'll see you soon.
Wow, so I'm sweating as well. I've been doing my burpees. I did the whole thing. Yeah, I'm so proud of myself. Wow, that really is a wow. I have nothing to say, sir. I'm speechless. Right, let's go to the chat window and see what the communication in the chat window looks like. There were a couple of discussions at the start of the workout, sir, in regards to person A or person B. I think most of that replied actually said that, you know, the jar was always half filled for them. A lot of thank yous have come through now. What an amazing session to you and your team. So whilst we've got you here, could you just tell us what P will be like for this young year sevens, well, year six to be year sevens when they start in September?
Yeah, of course you can. So you should have 2 PE lessons a week. As I said, one of them will be this WOW session, and then every half term, so every 6 or so weeks, you do a different sport. Okay, so I'll tell you now, football won't be on that curriculum, not because we're not a football school, we hate it. We love football. You will have football clubs after school. Okay, there's a boys club, there's a girls club. At the moment, the girls club is being run by Charlton as well. So we've just started girls football last year. So hopefully there's some young ladies watching here who are fantastic footballers who are going to help us get into the leagues again next year and do well in that. So you'll do things like rugby, handball, netball, dance. We have a phenomenal gymnastics suite here. I don't know if any of you are from Upland School and know Caroline, who taught gymnastics there. She owns a gymnastics club and they have one of our halls, and it's all set up with a sprung floor. So we do gymnastics in there. We can get you doing vaults and all sorts. That's absolutely amazing. And then, of course, in the summer, you do things like tennis, cricket, softball, rounders. So you'll do your WOW one lesson, and then let's say, for argument's sake, between September and half term, you might do rugby. And then when you come back after half term, you might do netball. Okay, and each group will do something different, but you'll all do the same thing.
Great, thank you for that, sir. I'm not sure if you can see the chat windows. A couple of comments have come through. Cobbler said he needed a workout, so thanks for that. It's a lot of thank yous, obviously. Do we play table tennis, or is that something that we do as a club activity?
Some very clever eagle-eyed person spotted my fantastic table tennis balls behind me at times at tables. Yes, there is table tennis. I can't promise you do everything in year seven. We try, I think we go through about 18 different sports between year seven and year nine. So you will get to do it at some point. Depending on my staff, depends on what clubs we can run. So at the moment, our department is about seven strong, but three members of that are on the senior leadership team. So their time is spent doing stuff, what we call up a big school, because we're a little bit away in the PE department. So that leaves me with about four members of staff here. So depending on what our timetable looks like, depends on how many lunchtime clubs we can run. And then obviously the after-school clubs need to be things like football, rugby and netball, because we compete against the other schools in those. If we can fit a table tennis club in, we would love to do it for you. But yeah, you'll definitely get to play table tennis at some point.
And next question, sir, is there badminton?
Yeah, again, we have, so this is, we call this our drama hall. This is kind of like our fitness suite and our table tennis hall. And then just down the corridor, we've got a much bigger hall called the sports hall. There's a space for four badminton courts in there. So again, that is something you'll do in lessons in either year seven, eight or nine. And again, if we're able to, we'll put a club on, but I can't promise those things just because of staffing numbers again.
Okay. So Razak has come back to remember person A and B.
Yes.
Effin. Razak has more to say about that. Fantastic. So what would you say you were, Mr. Sheehan? Were you A or B? I was more A, to be fair. But
No, I was definitely person B. Mr. Hills jumped in and did the entire workout. I used my lack of voice and my chest as an excuse to have to keep taking time out. Could I have pushed through? Probably, but hey-ho, my chest and voice was a good excuse for me to have breaks and make Mr. Hills and Mr. Penny work harder. So I probably was person B, yes.
Okay. And what about Mr. Penny? What person was he, A or B?
I'd probably say I was about half and half. I got a bit tough. Say. I tried to, as much as I could, to persevere a little bit on.
I thought you were A when you started, and then I watched.
Yeah, they sort of, yeah.
Momentum kind of plummeted.
Yeah, sort of dropped.
Okay, thank you so much, sirs. Right, year six, are you ready for the bit that you all love so much? And we know what that is. It is the one and only. So here is the shout out from the participation, or your participation in our last session, so the art session. So as you know, we always start by saying well done to X amount of people for literally taking part. Okay, here we go. So well done to Charlotte from Bramson Primary School, Aiden from Northumberland, Leia from Northumberland as well, Luke, from Brampton Primary School, Praise from Castilian Primary School. That's perfect. Cobner from Beedenwell, Jamie from Upland, and Celine from St. Joan Roan. So can we give a round of applause for those people? Okay, so the next bit is who came fifth place. So let's go to the chat window. We're looking for who, what school actually do you reckon came fifth position today? Is it Upland? Is it Wickham? Is it Beedenwell? Is it Alexandra McLeod Primary School? Who do we reckon? What's the chat window saying? Of course, you're always looking forward to the students' shout out. Of course, you always look forward to that, definitely. Okay, so the primary school at fifth position goes to Parkway Primary School, and the student we're going to be clapping for is Mohammed. Well done, Mohammed. You should be very proud of yourself, Mohammed, for coming fifth place. As you can see, the competition is always very, very tight. Okay, so in fourth position, what primary school do we reckon is going to be at fourth position? Is it Beedenwell? Is it Upland? Is it Wickham? Is it Hillgrove? Oh, Bursted Woods. Is it Bursted Woods? That's a really good one, Bradley. It could be. Right, are we ready for this? Upland at fourth position. Who do we reckon? Are there any students from Upland in here? Of course there is. Let's see. I remember seeing an Upland in the comment. Yep. Is it going to be Ava? Because obviously Ava is from Upland. Ava, do you reckon it's going to be you? Who else is here from Upland? Oh, there's too many chat for me to scroll down. Okay, so, and the student in fourth place is... Well done to Ava. Ava, that was a guess, actually. I didn't know it was you. Well done. And in third position, the primary school in third position, can we have a guess? Let's see. I wonder if a school can actually come first, second, third. Could be, actually. We've had that with Bursterswood, didn't we? I think they came first and third position. Was it in the science one? Okay. Bijin, the funniest thing is you keep nominating Bursted Woods. However, you're not even from Bursted Woods. That's very, very balanced, isn't it? Very nice of you, because normally people just actually think it's their school that's going to win it. Okay, so the primary school is East Wickham. Well done. There's a few East Wickhams in the house. Okay, let's see. Who is it going to be? Who's East Wickham? Okay, is it going to be Razak is the only East Wickham I see at the moment. I know I've seen a few others in the chat earlier on, but once again, there's so many chats to go through to look through for the schools. Okay, so any ideas who it might be? I wonder if it's Razak. And the winning student for third position goes to Razak. Well done, Razak. Yeah. Great guess, Bijane. Okay, so second position. So what primary school do we reckon is going to come second place? Ooh. So we've had Upland already. Could it be Hillgrove? Farid, do you reckon it could be you? Or Bradley? Do you reckon it could be you? Do you reckon it could be your school, Bradley? Cobner? Could it be your school? Okay, let's put you out of your misery. Okay, so second position goes to Beedenwell. Well done, Beedenwell. Who was here from Beedenwell? I remember seeing a name from Beedenwell. Yeah, too many chats. Okay, and second place goes to Charlie D. Well done, Charlie. Charlie, if you're watching now, well done. And we have got into that prime position, which is first place. Is it going to be a tie? Or is it going to be just one person? And if it's a tie, is it going to be from two different schools? Interesting, wouldn't it? Right, so drum roll, let's get our drums ready. Okay, so what primary school? It's in the chat window. Razak is just super impressed that he got third position. We're ready in the chat window. And the primary school in first place today is May Place. Well done to May Place. Oh, sorry, Grace. It wasn't Hillgrove. No, it wasn't Belmont either. I do apologize. Maybe next week. Maybe you can do the checkout for the P session and literally hit first place. Okay, who do you reckon is the student we're going to be celebrating today at position number one? Who is it? I'm going to give you 10 seconds. Oh, Charlotte, were you hoping that was Brampton? I do. Oh, that's a shame. But you know what? We've got one more session next week. So, Charlotte, fingers crossed, maybe Brampton might just come first place for next week. And the winning student is Nathan W. from May Place. Well done. Okay, now, year six, we're almost at the end of today's session. My suggestion for you would be when you complete your checkout for today, can you make sure you put your first name in full, right? And then give us your initial as well. So there's more than one from your school. We know exactly which one we're giving the prizes to. Any questions before we go? So well done to all for taking part in today's session. And for those of you watching us as a recorded session, please make sure you complete the checkout, because what I want to do is I want to be able to celebrate every single person that is taking part. And the only way I can know who is taking part is by you completing your checkout. Now, if you complete the worksheet, there wasn't much to do on there because a lot of it was you literally thinking about the workout that Sarah was going to do and comparing person A and person B. So there's no need to submit it to Sarah. But if you really, really wanted to, you can email those worksheets to me and I'll forward that to Sarah or the PE department. Okay, so well done, everybody, for taking part in today's session. Any questions before we go? Last 30 seconds. I love this whole... Okay. Thank you so much for taking part. And from all of us here at BA, have a fantastic day tomorrow at school. Remember what Mr. Sheehan said. Make sure you go into school tomorrow. I do not want to get phone calls from your primary schools saying, blah, 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 didn't come into school today because they did this wow PE lesson at BA and they are in pain. The more movement you give your muscles, the better you're going to feel. Have a lovely weekend and I look forward to seeing you next week for your horrible history session. Take care, everyone.